I had to wait until the end of like the lesson to check the email. The email was like, the subject line wasn't very clear. It didn't really say if I'd gotten or not. So I had to click on it. I was waiting for it to load. The Wi-Fi was really bad. And then I had to go out, and then it finally loaded, and then I realized I was in. So I didn't really know anything about Cambridge until around year 12. I moved school for sixth form, and my new school had a really good careers advisor and a really good head teacher who were really on the ball with everything. And they organized quite a few trips. We went to Trinity Hall and we stayed there for a night, and that was really my first experience of Cambridge. We got a tour around like all the different colleges. We had talks by students and things like that. And it was like the first real insight into Cambridge. And I got the opportunity to meet people who'd come from the Northeast as well. And that was probably the biggest motivator for me coming to Cambridge. I applied on a gap year. I had quite a lot of free time. I got quite a lot of help from my school in terms of, they still helped me out with my personal statement and things like that, even though I technically wasn't at the school anymore. So I did my application, but then I also did quite a few like supercurricular activities. So I entered myself with some maths competitions, for example. I tutored as well, and I just tried to keep myself busy and keep myself interested in like the subject area I was applying for. I didn't really do much direct preparation for the interview. It was more so just making sure I was comfortable with everything I learned in school and that I knew everything I talked about in my personal statement. And I'd had practice talking to people, for example, through tutoring. And it was more about the indirect skills than the sort of practicing an interview, because the interview is quite special. It's its own thing, and you want to make sure you're comfortable with anything they could ask you. So Jesus College were really helpful actually when I was coming to interview. I came all the way from Newcastle and I had to come on the train, so they organised two nights of accommodation for me. They put me up in Chapel Court free of charge and gave me meal vouchers, and they really tried really hard to make me feel comfortable. I'd done job interviews beforehand, but it really wasn't anything like that. The interviews were really nice actually, to be honest. I was really scared going in, thinking I'd get completely grilled and things like that, but they were just really friendly. They didn't expect me to know everything as soon as I walked into the interview. I did struggle with some questions, as expected, and they were just really helpful in giving me tips and giving me advice and to get through the questions. It's been said a million times before, but yeah, they don't expect you to know everything as soon as you walk in, and they want to see people do well. Most interviewers don't want to have a bad interview, they want everyone to do well. So they are really helpful, and they were really helpful to me. But I think I've got a better focus of maybe what I want to do, at least at uni. But I am still trying to keep my options open. I haven't really decided my career yet. But I feel like I have quite a lot of help, and for example, we have the career service at Cambridge, which has been quite helpful. They organise a lot of events. I am still trying to keep my options open because I don't want to restrict myself too early, and I want to make sure I do something that I like, and if I do end up doing something I don't like, I know that I can switch.